was walking above cliffs on a beautifully laid out easy path with possible snakes on both sides of it, the clouds, the vegetation, some houses, and the breaking sound of the ocean waves, she was reflecting on how much she liked her pen name, Ada, A-D-A. It had significance both in her native language, and she wanted to mean amore, divino, assoluto, as well as in English, where she meant it as absolute divinity anchor. Because in her 70 years of a life full of unpredictable twists and turns, and totally enriched by them, despite the hardships that she certainly hadn't lacked, she realized finally, after always being interested in the development of comparative religion and the such, that behind everything one does and behind everything one chooses at every single one moment, there are so many choices, and when we make the right ones, they bring us closer to universal love. Gone were the times when to find terrestrial love, she was looking for young, testosterone-filled, healthy males who, more than being interested in a true, well-blended relationship involving spirit as well as knowledge as well as body, were more inclined to enjoy the carnal sides of life. So let's say Ada had moved away from kissing and getting involved more than that with such a number of, let's call them frog princes. And she found more and more that at 70 she felt more confidence in life and very happy about the choices she was making. She was walking along the beach for a little while, and then taking time to integrate the external beauty manifesting around her with her inner state, being very grateful that she was able to still find areas within the beautiful state of Western Australia where there was the luxury of enjoying at least 1,600 species of magnificent bushes and flowers and plants. Yet, a bit sad, knowing that the pollution that society at that point in time was having effect on the water that people drink, on the air, on the ground itself where products grow. As she was walking above cliffs on a beautifully laid out easy path with possible snakes on both sides of it, the clouds, the vegetation, some houses, and the breaking sound of the ocean waves, she was reflecting on how much she liked her pet. Reflection and aloneness had become habits that she really enjoyed. She really thrived on the ability to put everything together in the map for this mosaic that life is. As Ada was continuing on her walk, she stopped because she was distracted by seeing one of the youth hostel's guests whom she had only just met on the night she had arrived. This particular lovely soul, Tuada, did not look that grounded and that serene, and the fact that she seemed to enjoy her alcoholic drinks and very receptive to sharing others' vegetarian meal made her a little uncomfortable as far as her health was concerned, because she could tell this beautiful lady had a very nice soul, yet her external manner and appearance reminded Ada of herself. Not that she ever got into any alcoholic habit, but mainly because she too was overweight for several years of her life. She too at times looked down and a bit disturbed by life. So this opportunity of finding this person along the path walking in the opposite direction really made her feel so good, because they stopped, they talked, and as she had noticed that same very morning, this new person met for a brief span of Ada's life already was showing improvement in her countenance and in her external manifestation of energy. As they were conversing about various life skills, including the fact that if we crave for a certain color, it's probably a message from our body trying to tell us that we lack certain vitamins and minerals which we could get from food or energetic vibrations that that color emanates. So we might decide to either have that food or to wear something or look at something of that particular color. Some other life techniques came up to raise vibrations and to feel serene, such as some pieces of Mozart's music and Beethoven's, which are not necessarily everyone's cup of tea. And above all, Ada was so proud and said so of seeing this new gentle soul looking so more radiant than when she first had arrived, and to have the opportunity to together share some of that sacred, beautiful energy that's so pure and we call love, unconditional love. By now you're well aware of how in Ada's internal world the word reflection, the verb to reflect, the gerund reflecting, was so vital to her new transformative call in her essence. because of the provision of insight connecting her spirit to the spirit of other dimensional beings, helping us from higher perspectives. And the work that together we are all doing to eventually reach the light again. By the same token, she also realized that everyone has got their choices and their consciousness to become or not become aware of the direction they're taking at any one moment. And therefore, when she engaged in those talks, which seemed to come from her mouth more and more often, then she must try to take over the conversation, not to convince anyone of anything. And she would often follow by saying, "This is where my research has led me. Please do your own research and never believe anything anyone tells you until when you feel that it resonates with you." And trying, whenever aware of it, get rid of her ego. She recognized that it is not where serenity comes from, nor where the good essence of all we are is fed. And she put into practice more and more, and it was becoming easier and easier, the discovery by some scientists, quantum science, that we all have those 17 seconds in which to turn a negative thought for which we're programmed to a positive one. So as she became more and more aware of our judging mind, she would change that, either imagining a beautiful picture of some of the many situations she had experienced herself in life, with friends, with animals, with art pieces and other natural gifts that give us the right vibes and emotions, or by simply using the easiest technique and fastest technique that she knew, which was using the white light that encompasses everything to go over that thought of negativity or judgment or anger or fear or stress or any other non-positive emotion, engulfing it with the vibrations of all the spectrum of all colors possible that are encompassed in this beautiful white light or spirit. And often she would imagine a huge heart of red of unconditional love going over it. And it was becoming easier and easier to have more and more magical days and more rewarding life affirmations and experiences. She was just so grateful about everything she was learning. As she was sharing more openly, left, right and center, with close friends, other friends, or even complete strangers, the more we practice certain skills, the better we get at making them part of our daily living. And if we choose to stay in serenity, some things where light and love prevail, then makes usually people feel much better, then the same energies are attracted towards that light and increase the picture in beautiful natural ways a thousandfold. How lucky were Australians indeed to have such glorious beaches that looked uncontaminated, that allowed the beautiful force of the ocean waves to express themselves in the full potential, that enabled nature to continue living in some sort of pristine fashion compared to much of what had been happening in so many parts of the world, totally destroyed by ecological disasters and the like.
Just as it happens in our minds with thoughts coming and going, that in meditation we try to just let be without concentrating on them. Who knows? Maybe one day this story will be written down, parts of it will be changed, others will be added, or maybe it won't. Who knows? So much in the future is for us to decide and move towards, but nothing is granted. So let's enjoy the moment. Let's enjoy whatever might have been stimulated by listening to someone else's tales of wonder, and see what happens. If we always stay on the highest vibration of communication between heart and mind, within ourselves, spirit and others, we simply cannot go wrong. Enjoy life at every single moment. Don't forget about nature. Nature really is the essence. They try to imitate it in architecture, in art, in fabrics, in all sorts of things, yet its perfection is still elusive, because nothing yet that is replicating what we see in our beautiful world at the natural aspect of beautiful scenery with trees, bushes, beautiful hills, rivers, oceans and so on can ever be replicated exactly the same. So let us live in the moment as much as we can. That's all we're granted we have. And let's be grateful, grateful always for every single beautiful blessing that life bestows us. Namaste.